Here at Fox 17 News, we are committed to informing you about the big issues, and few are bigger here in Middle Tennessee than transportation. Tonight, Fox 17 held a special town hall meeting, Your Voice, Your Future, on various transportation challenges that come with our growing population. Fox 17's Sky Arnold live at the event at Trevecca University with the story tonight. Sky?
Well, Stacey, no surprise. The big topic tonight turned out to be the AMP. Of course, it's a proposed rapid bus service that would run from East Nashville down Broadway and West End to White Bridge Road. And we heard a lot of questions about it today, including its cost and even its safety.
Is AMP a done deal?
Why was the West End corridor the only one studied?
By whose authority are you spending our taxpayers' money?
We heard a lot of questions about the proposed rapid bus service called the AMP. The project would take away three lanes of traffic down some of Nashville's busiest avenues for a quicker bus service. And this woman worries how that will impact emergency vehicles.
If you're going to take that center lane out, which is very crucial when traffic's backed up and you've got ambulances and fire engines.
Metro Transit's Thomas O'Connell assures her those ambulances will be able to use the AMP's lanes to get around.
In fact, be much safer bypassing the rest of traffic and being able to access, for instance, the fire hall, the hospitals.
Our panel of transportation experts includes several people involved in planning the AMP.
My neighborhood needs this connection.
Along with a local group that's fighting it.
The corridor upon which this is proposed is the wealthiest, most prosperous corridor in the city. It does not need help with development.
Jennifer Pennington fielded one of the tougher questions of the night when this AMP supporter asked why her group believes the buses will hurt West End.
Cleveland says they've seen $4 billion invested in the Euclid Avenue corridor since their $200 million investment.
Did you read anything about the businesses that were shuttered because of the BRT in Cleveland and Charlotte and other places?
I've read about the $4 billion that they say would not have been invested.
Certainly a little disagreement there. Now, if you'd like to watch our special on transportation in its entirety, we're going to air it right here on Fox 17, September the 18th at noon. Now, of course, the town hall meeting just wrapped up not long ago. We did get some interesting reactions to it. We're going to air those coming up tonight at 10. For now, Sky Arnold, live at Trevecca Nazarene's Fox 17 News.